for the final event of the afternoon. Trust you've enjoyed Merton Cup Day. We're about to get underway for the last. There they go, they're on their journey. Delrazi came out well. Fortune 500 in the fluorescent colours, and Yelta's there with the pink cap in the middle. And 9 miles, Luskin Bell, I beg your pardon, is the last one on settling down, and it's Delrazi who waits for no man in front, and it rolls along and it goes the best part of five. In second place in was Fortune 500. Yelta holds down the inside in third, and 6 lengths away at the tail end of the field was Luskin Bell. I couldn't predict too much change. This leader is absolutely low flying in front. It's Delrazi, as it likes to do, though, and it goes out to the back of the track, and it goes out by, that's probably 8 lengths clear to Yalta running second, and Fortune 500's the one running third, and the stablemate to the cut winner, Luskin Bell, is at the tail end of the field as they go down the side. And it's Delrazi at the top end. Delrazi leads the way for Craig Kirkpatrick, the race favourite in the last. It goes clear by 8 lengths. In second place in was Yalta, Fortune 500 was third, and last of all was Luskin Bell, who's got a big task from there, but Delrazi certainly strung them along. And it's out by 5 lengths down the side. Yelta's the horse in pursuit for Courtney Pace, who's had a big day. She's after one more in the last, and it takes out after Delrazi. Fortune 500, the outsider, is running third. And Luskin Bell is starting to tack on at the tail end of the field. Delrazi, it's been a brave ride. It leads them to the corner, but Yalta is coming up and getting closer with every bound. Then followed by Luskin Bell, who's gone past Fortune 500. They turn homeward bound. Delrazi's in front. Yelta's been the horse who's been chasing from a long way out, draws up alongside Delrazi. Yalta the outside, got the head in front, did the chasing work and ran over the top of them. Yalta got the job down. Delrazi was second and brave. Luskin Bell's ran third, made a fair bit of ground too, and Fortune 500 was the last one to clock in.